my wife sent this in for you.
Why
Welcome everyone to church. Welcome as we come together on the Lord's Day. It's so good to be gathered here on the Sunday before Thanksgiving, a beautiful time in the life of the church and a beautiful time in the changing of the seasons. Have a number of announcements in the life of the church. First of all, greeting those who are welcome. Welcome to you who are joining us online. So many of you are starting to chime in and telling friends about it. They can have a look at Door Village, and then as you're inviting them, maybe later be able to come in person. So welcome to you. If this is your first time here, just glad you could make it here today. Please pick up your newsletter from the greeters table if you do not already receive it by email. Now, to switch to the email version, just leave your current email address at the greeters table. Getting a newsletter by email does save the church time and money. It is a help if you do. Switching is easy. Just leave your email address with us. Our Wednesday after school program is called Kids Club. It's for kids kindergarten through fourth grade and meets here at the church from 3:30 to 5:15 on Wednesdays. This week, they do not meet. No kids club this week because of the Thanksgiving holiday. But next week, their program will be, woohoo, Christmas, decorating Christmas cookies. Wow. I'll be there maybe. We are collecting items for college care packets. The table is just outside the sanctuary. This year we'll be sending out 13 of them, so shop accordingly. I just went over a list on some of the items for suggestions. Microwave popcorn is always popular. A deck of playing cards, maybe those pocket Kleenexes can go in the box very easily. Many bags of chips, pretzels, crackers, and the like. Energy bars or protein bars, maybe hard candy or gum. Gift card, this is a new item. Gift cards of for coffee or fast food. If you're inclined to send a blessing off to our college kids, think about gift cards. And then maybe something a little Christmas, an ornament or a Christmas game. Small items. And then this is our way of letting them know we're thinking of them during finals week. And then also I want to continue to highlight collecting items for Salvation Army. I heard word that people are coming in and they really do need more items on the shelf at the Salvation Army. And one way we can help is by targeting the items they need. By that I mean we're collecting peanut butter and jelly. So next week or during the week, this week, bring in a jar of peanut butter and a jar of jelly. All that means is take time as you shop or go by the store, put an extra peanut butter and an extra jelly in your shopping cart and have it here Sunday. I want to fill our collection box out here so that we can fill the shelf out there. The need is great. I just want you to know. Don't hesitate on this one. Everybody participate. Let's do our part to feed those who are hungry in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Are there any other announcements in the life of the church? I see, yes, Beverly.
You mentioned something about the college care packages. Next Sunday is the last Sunday to bring.
Oh, yeah, bring it this week or Sunday. Right. But that's it. That's the time we have to collect them.
So that they get them in time.
Yes. I didn't mention it. Thank you. Thank you. No other announcements? Let's open with a word of prayer. It's so good to be gathered together here as your people, and we're grateful for so many things. The old hymn is right. Count your blessings. Name them by one. And we do. In this Thanksgiving season, we count our many blessings and we see what you have done, Lord. Bless us, we pray, as we worship and honor you in this way today. And to that we all say an amen. Say amen, everyone.
Amen.
And now stand and greet one another. Say hello to those worshiping with us today.
Good morning. Please join me in sharing the call to worship. Give thanks to the Lord.
He is worthy of all our thanks and praise.
Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. The fields have yielded their harvest, and God has greatly provided.
Praise the Lord. Bless his holy name. Amen.
Please stand if you're able and join in singing opening hymn number 131, We Gather Together. The words will be on the screen.
I do have a prayer request that came our way. The Jeff Council and his family just want to express their thank you and their gratitude for keeping them in prayer in this season that they're going through right now. Continued prayers for the Council family. Others? Prayer concerns. I'm going to spin this way. Hi, Jan.
Yeah, prayers for my sister, Kathy. She's having a surgery in Chicago this Wednesday for a lymphedema in her arm following having breast cancer. So it's a very intricate procedure. We're hoping for the best. And for travel mercies for us as we leave again.
Yes, yes. We have you covered. Prayers for Sister Kathy.
Yes.
Your sister Kathy facing surgery. Oh, I see you, Annie.
Continued prayers for my sister-in-law, Ned, who suffered a stroke about a month or so ago. She is going home after rehabilitation, but it was very debilitating. She's lost the complete right side and the ability to speak very well. So we continue to keep her in our prayers.
And the first name is Beth?
Annette.
Annette.
Yes, thank you.
I thought I had that. Prayers for Annette. Mary?
My sister in law in Florida had back surgery, and she's having a rough road.
Okay. Prayers for Lynn, who has had back surgery, and it's we need prayer. We need prayer, Mary. Yes. I'll go right here. Yes, John.
I want to just praise and thank everybody for.
It's good to see you, John, Celeste. Yes, good to see you. It's been a road. It's been a road, John, and the Lord has brought you here to this place. And you are loved, and you have been prayed over all the way through. All the way through, our hearts have been watching over and caring for you. You are loved, of course, by God, but by us as well. It's good to see you in church. And I see Mike.
Yes, praise for the Bears' new offensive coordinator. He actually knows stuff.
Is this answered prayer from last week?
No, I don't know if you can fix that one or not.
No, you prayed for this last week and it happened, so is that...
It's a roundabout thing, that's all. Now they have to do something with it.
Well, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised here in God's sanctuary. Everyone say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And I need another... A different prayer concern now. I have to do this.
Oh, for me? Well, that's probably a good one. It's a challenge.
It takes a lot to stump the pastor, and you got me. You got me.
I'll take that for $10.
I see Mary.
I just want to have a praise for my husband's 91st birthday.
And all I can say is the Lord's got you here for a reason. He's not done with you yet. We're not done with you. So praise the Lord and serve the Lord with a glad heart, bud. The Lord's got you. You've been walking with Him many years now. Many years with the Lord. Yes.
He's been just with me all the time.
Yes. Yes, praise the Lord. I see you, Joe.
A friend of mine, Bonnie Quigley, and I'm sure a friend of a lot of you, everybody here, especially First Church, she's been diagnosed with liver cancer. She has stopped working on glass beads of radiation injected right into the liver.
Okay.
She wants all the terms she can get.
Bonnie Quick. Got it. Prayers for Bonnie. She'll be on our weekly prayer list, and then as we receive updates, we'll continue prayer. And Sue.
Yeah, Joy, Kevin and Stephanie just celebrated their 22nd wedding anniversary yesterday.
We just watch over our kids, don't we? We watch over them, we care for them in prayer, and this is a joy that has come our way through Kevin Stephanie. God bless them. God bless them. And yeah, that's Jerry.
John Harper is home after his open heart surgery and is doing well.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for answered prayer. All right, let's go to the Lord in silent prayer, lifting our hearts. This is just you. This is just God. Just talk to God for a minute. No? I see the bullpen going here.
We do have a joy. We had lunch today, chili supper, and then afterwards hanging in the greens.
You know what? I did go right past that, didn't I? Yeah, I did. After church, if you would like to stay, we put out some Christmas items, and then downstairs, I personally would like to invite all of you to come downstairs and take home a Christmas ornament. There are 1,000 down there, 1,000 ornaments. Please do, if you have time, stop by downstairs, pick up an ornament, and head that out to start your Christmas season. Pardon?
And eat chili.
Oh, if you want to stop and stay and have some chili, that's fine too. A very generous donation came to the church from a family. They lost their loved one to COVID about 4 or 5 years ago, and very dear to my heart. I'm helping the widow take care of things, empty the house a little bit, but they're gorgeous ornaments. So stop by for that. And there's also Christmas items out that are out. If you would like to purchase any of those, they are for sale. But it's if you want it, make a donation. But it's about getting the ornaments to a place where they can be loved and appreciated, because of a dear friend of mine that made that donation to the church. So thank you. You guys, for keeping me on track there. Now this is the time. Just take a moment and talk to God. You may not have talked to him in a while. It may have been just this morning. Just say something. God is listening. God cares. God loves. You can say you're sorry if you're sorry for something. You can say, I'm grateful. If you're grateful for something on this Sunday before Thanksgiving, you pray. This is silent prayer. You pray. And yes, Lord, the need can be great, but you are a great God, and you hear and answer prayer. For Jeff Council, hear us, Lord, as we lift him up to you and the family. Prayers for Kathy as she's facing surgery, and for Annette, who's had this stroke. Lord, we just name them again to you. For Lynn, that we've lifted up because of this back. And then we're so very grateful for Celeste and John being here with us. And Lord, our closeness to them and their closeness to you. We have a wonderful birthday we're celebrating at 91 years for Bud. And Lord, for Bonnie, this liver cancer, Lord, you know. And you can be a help. You can bring comfort, kindness, love, fellowship, friendship. For Kevin and Stephanie and their celebration of this anniversary, we're grateful. And then also for Harder being home now, but still continued prayer for him. We ask all these things because we know who you are. But more than that, Lord, you know who we are. You are our needs, our desires, our wants. We love you, Lord, because you first loved us. And now we seek you in prayer the way you taught us to pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Amen and amen. Okay, now it's time for us to collect our coins. The little ones will be coming around with their collection containers. And if you have some coins that you'd like to donate to the Mission Fund, it is a great way to help out. I'll also mention Diane Plotner at this time. Keep her in our prayers. She's coming out of a medical situation, and she needs strength. So continued. We're thinking of you, Diane. I know you watch online. I know you do. And we're thinking of you. We're collecting these coins so that the mission committee that you head up can do wonderful work for the Lord. There you go. Good job. Good job. Those go in there. These go in here. Oh, that too. Is this pop tabs? Nope, it goes in there. Good job. Stack your buckets. Can I do that one for you? And then can you get that one? And then we'll stack them right there. Lucy? Got it? You know what? I didn't think we had enough buckets. Wow. I'm going to sneak through here. Can I sneak right through here? Okay, I want you all to stand up and let's go to the altar. Let's head this way. Now, I want to talk about a particular item that is on the altar today. And an altar was a place that they placed their offerings to God, okay? It's where they placed their offerings to God. And in the fall, after all the crops would come in, they would bring their offerings and place them on the altar. Now, what I want to talk to you about on the altar is right here. What do I got here? A pumpkin. This time of year, in fall, pumpkins usually are ripe and ready, and they become part of our Thanksgiving meal. What do you make with the pumpkin?
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie, yeah, pumpkin pie. Now, we can make pumpkin pie any time of the year, but there's nothing like pumpkin pie during Thanksgiving, right? Right? To celebrate the mighty pumpkin, I thought I would tell you what, follow the leader. Come out this way. Along the communion rail are mini pumpkins, and you each get to take one. So go ahead and pick out your pumpkin. Now, we don't make, that's fine if you want that one, that's good. You're not going to make pumpkin pies with these. These are to put out for Thanksgiving. Some people put them on their front porch, some people put them on a table in the corner, whatever. Ask somebody where is the best place that you can display those, okay? And that is a gift for you from the abundance and the bounty of Christ our Lord. That means the crops came in. Coulter's farm had all these pumpkins and made sure that we had some for y'all today, okay? Let's pray. Can you fold your hands together around your pumpkin? There you go. And join us in this prayer. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Come into my heart today. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Come into my heart today. Let me hear the kids say amen.
Amen.
Let me hear everyone else say amen.
Amen.
And you are? Out of here. Hear now this morning's invitation to share. I have with me thank you notes that were included in our thankful offering, and they have been encouraging me all week, and I wanted to share some of them with you. Thankful for our church, whose mission is to make disciples of Jesus Christ, and thank for this church welcoming us and making our transition so easy. We are thankful for Pastor Sam. And then thankful for health, for home, family, and for friends. Thankful for our wonderful church, the center of our village, and the home for our spiritual learning and life. Praise the Lord. I'm thankful for family and friends. It takes a village to raise a child, and I have found my village here with friends. This one is salvation. Thankful for salvation. Thankful for a church family. They are a comfort and a blessing. Thankful for all. First of all, we are thankful for Jesus. Without him, nothing else would matter. And thank you for family. Thank you for our country and for the freedoms we have. Thankful for God's faithfulness. Thankful for God watching over me. And this one, I'm thankful for my Lord and my Savior, my husband, my family, and friends. Thankful for all the opportunities I'm given and for the family I have. I'm seeing some themes here, aren't you? Prayer of thanksgiving every day to be able to share with my family, church family, and friends. We are also blessed with those God has placed in our lives. And one last one. It's hard to put down on paper how grateful I really am for my Door Village Church family. The love and support of many people have shaped me into the Christian I am today. Together we have witnessed baptisms, weddings, funerals, countless other moments in each other's lives. And God has shown grace and mercy to this church and to those who love him. So those are just some words of thankfulness on this Sunday before Thanksgiving. Thank you for sharing those with us, and thank you for sharing your Thanksgiving offering, your thankful offering with us. And the church is just blessed we are blessed to have each other and to have family. I heard that over and over again in these thankful cards. Thank you for sharing those with us. Now let's stand for the doxology. Lord, the bounty comes from you. You provide the seed. We watch over it, but you provide the sun and the rain and the wind and the warmth. And Lord, you provide fruit. You provide the harvest, and we are blessed. In your name, we pray. Amen. Everyone says an amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Our scripture reading this morning is from 2 Corinthians 9, verses 5 to 11. So I thought it necessary to urge the brothers to visit you in advance and finish the arrangements for the generous gift you had promised. Then it will be ready as a generous gift, not as one grudgingly given. Remember this, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows generously will also reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, and not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver, and God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. As it is written, they have freely scattered their gifts to the poor, their righteousness endures forever. Now he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will also supply and increase your store of seed and will enlarge the harvest of your righteousness. You will be enriched in every way so that you can be generous on every occasion, and through us your generosity will result in thanksgiving to God. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Now, this Sunday is a Sunday of transition. We move into our final Sunday before Advent season begins. Before Advent, we finish the fall season by being thankful in our hearts. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Thank you, Lord, for making me whole. Thank you, Lord, for giving to me thy great salvation, so rich and free. On this Sunday before Thanksgiving, I'm thankful, thankful for so many things. My faith in Jesus Christ, especially, that I have the opportunity to preach and teach and share who Christ is with all of you and with all of those in my life. My faith in Jesus Christ. I remember the day I came to faith in Christ as a teenager. I prayed and the whole church prayed with me that day. I thank God. I thank God. What are you thankful for? Let's go down this road. What are you thankful for? I heard so many thankful moments in our notes that I shared from the thankful offering. Truly grateful hearts. And I'm grateful for my church home as well, and my church home growing up. How I was taught the principles of biblical tithing that we heard about in our scripture reading for today. I learned about the principle of offering first fruits. Everybody say that phrase with me. Say first fruits. First fruits. Now, what does that mean? What does that mean? I can still hear my pastor saying, give God your best, not just what's left. I'll remember that as long as I live. The scripture that teaches the principle that we're talking about is found in Proverbs 9, 3, Proverbs 3, 9 through 10. Honor the Lord with your wealth, with the first fruits of all your crops. Then your barns will be filled to overflowing, and your vats will brim over with new wine. First fruits, first fruits. I remember getting my first paycheck. I was a bagger at the grocery store, and my first check was for $16 for the week. Before I did anything with that check, I took that $1.60 and I placed it in an envelope in the offering plate. I so began my rudimentary relationship with what is called tithing in the Bible. First fruits, off the top. The first, the best. And then later, checks were a little more than that. And the Lord would bless me with more work and more hours and more pay. And I would recalculate my tithe on an ongoing basis. And in those early years, it was always down to the penny. I would put in 13 cents. From a scripture in Malachi 3:10, it encouraged me in my life of giving. It said this: bring the whole tithe into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. Test me in this, says the Lord Almighty, and see if I will not throw open the floodgates of heaven and pour out so much blessing that there will not be room enough to store it. These were encouraging words to me as a young believer. And in this verse, I learned to trust. I learned to believe the promises of God found in Scripture. And as time went on, though, I'll confess this to you. I got a little bit lazy. A little bit lazy. I rounded to the nearest dollar and did away with the coins. I turned into just opening my wallet on a Sunday morning and giving some of what was there, you know, way more than that initial $1.60 of tithing that I had started at, but nowhere near what a true tithe that the Lord was calling me to give. I would just put something in the plate, regardless of my current situation. If I was abounding and being blessed, the amount would stay the same, or if times were tough, I'd still just put in the same amount every week. Then years passed, and once again, at my church, it was teaching about the practice of tithing, reminding me. They handed out a simple form. It was just a piece of paper. Write on the top line what the Lord had blessed you with financially that week. Then simply figure, move the decimal point. For those of you who do math, just move the decimal point, and there you have it, a tithe. Just that simple. I think that sometimes we try to complicate things too much. Should we tithe on our net or our gross income? And do we only tithe on what's left after we pay our taxes and pension and insurance deductibles and all that other stuff? All I can say is this. In your giving, keep it simple and keep it genuine to your heart. Another scripture helped me with this part, with the heart part. Luke 6:38. Given, it will be given to you, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, it will be poured into your lap. For with the measure you use, it will be measured to you. And I started to find other ways to be generous above the tithing. It's called tithes and offerings. And I would make offerings to different, like to the Salvation Army food pantry and the like. Over the years, I've observed a variety of reactions to tithing as it's been taught in church. One response piqued my curiosity. I heard someone say that tithing was an Old Testament obligation. It was something from Old Testament, and we don't follow that. And he said that tithing was not in the New Testament at all. The truth is, tithing is found in both the Old Testament and the New Testament. I dove in, did a little research, and I found tithes and special offerings also encouraged in the New Testament. Matthew 23:23, for instance. Woe to you, teachers of the law and Pharisees, you hypocrites. You give a tenth of your spices, mint, dill, cumin. But you have neglected the more important matters of the law, justice, mercy, faithfulness. You should have practiced the latter without neglecting the former. Do you see it there, tithing? You did one, and you should be doing the other. Well, to me, that's tithing right there in the Gospel of Matthew. Now, I believe there's a good warning as well in this text about legalism. It's not about judging other people and what they're doing. It's about having a relationship with the Lord. It's not about being so meticulous in the calculation that you miss out on what God is asking you to do. Jesus has no time for legalism. Empty obedience, void of compassion, just doing it because you do it. Same offering. So that's tithing in the Gospels. I was looking a little deeper into the New Testament, and I found 2 Corinthians 9:7. It says this: each of you should give what you've decided to give, decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a what? God loves a, say it, cheerful giver. Cheerful giver. Do it with the right heart. Stay in that right relationship with God and with your finances. Now, let me be a little understanding here. If tithing or the word tithing just angers you or irks you because of past bad experiences from pushy preachers, I apologize for that. I apologize for that. If tithing seems unrealistic to you or unfair given your current financial reality, again, that's okay. God loves the cheerful giver. Find your way to joy in giving. What can you do? Well, do what it takes to be a cheerful giver. Gladly support the work of the church. Keep in mind that tithing is always about honoring God and thanking God for what He provides. It's not about all the other baggage that we try to tie to tithing. One of the ways to be a cheerful giver is to support special offerings or mission emphasis in the church. The kids collecting coins is an easy one. Wasn't there just joy in the sanctuary today? All those kids and all those coins coming in, and all for a good purpose. That's cheerful giving. That's cheerful giving. Or bringing food for the food pantry, for the Salvation Army box. Again, I'd like to see that box get filled this week. I'm just saying, challenging you. Step up, step up. The thankful offering that we have collected is an important one as well. Give with gratitude, tithe as the Lord leads you. I want to share just a brief word about the thankful offering that we collected this past month. It is simply an invitation to express your gratitude to God. That is why it was taken, thankfulness. It will go to the general fund of the church to support the ministries here at Door Village Church. There wasn't a special project or something. I had somebody ask me if the church was in trouble financially. Is that why we're taking an extra offering? And thankfully, the answer is no. That's not why we took the offering, and there isn't that dire need that you would take a special offering for. If there's a shortfall in giving, and if there is a great need in the church, I will express it openly and communicate that with you. I promise you that. I was the one who requested the special offering at harvest time in fall to connect us with God through thankfulness. This is the time of year when God's blessings overflow as the fields are harvested and the crops come in. God's blessing is evident, evident. I want all of us to connect to that gratitude and thankfulness for God's provision. It's not too late to participate in the thankful offering if you didn't have a chance. There's, I think, an envelope or two on the table back there. Many of you have already turned yours in a separate envelope. Thank you for that. If you have not, you can still turn that in. Gathering your amount throughout the month, just think of it as a sacrificial gift. Part of my gift this year was not going out to eat a couple times and then putting that in the offering envelope and getting to the church. You do you. You do you. Show your support. Show your gratitude. Show your faith. Show your trust in the Lord. Give generously. Be a cheerful giver. This year is ending and a new year is beginning. And so reconsider your relationship with tithing. Maybe you could take that simple process, write down the number, whatever number it is that God has provided for you, and then offer 10% of that to God's work. Try it once. Try it 1 week. Don't forget to adjust your income for changes in circumstances. If work is hard, if there's fewer resources coming in, you can adjust. That's always biblical. It's not a rigid, unchanging thing that we treat our giving to the church as sometimes. It ebbs, it flows with the seasonal tides of God's blessings. Simply give in proportion. They call it proportionate giving, as God has given to you. Now, as I'm out driving around and I see the empty fields, I'm aware once again that God has multiplied his blessings to us. That is the lesson of tithing. God multiplying his blessing to us. God's promises are true. His blessings overflow as we remain faithful believers. One last scripture before we finish. Philippians 4:19. It's a good memory verse. Jot it down maybe later. 4:19. Philippians 4:19. 4:19. You have it? And my God will meet all your needs according to his riches, according to the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus. According to his riches. God is rich and lavish with his love, even forgiving us of all sin. And to that we finish by saying, everyone says an amen. Amen, everyone. Amen. Amen. And let's finish with a harvest hymn. We'll stand and sing, "Come Ye Thankful People, Come." Let's stand. There will be a great harvest, a harvest of souls. And I look forward to that day. I look forward to that day. But till that day, Lord, let's pray. Let's pray. Lord, make me a faithful follower of you, supplying the needs of the church to do ministry in your name. We gather in your name. We work in your name. We help others in your name. Through what is given together, what no one of us could do alone, as we gather the offering together, there is a blessing there that we pass on to others. It's in your name we gather, in your name we pray, and in your name we are thankful. To that, all God's children say amen. Amen. Bless you on your way. Stop for chili, help hang around and decorate, or get your ornament downstairs. Bless you on your way. Yeah.